Are you already sewing, or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing.
Welcome to the Fear of Sewing series. These are the beginning shows with Sandra Betzina and my daughter Kim.
Hello.
And we're getting Kim excited. This one, I've decided this is a good pattern for a beginner, really, because it's so simple, and Kim happens to like it. Here
True.
It is. This is the pattern. And the number is Vogue 1071. And what it is it's a dolman sleeve, and it's actually a dress, but we can make a top out of it. You see, it has no set-in sleeve. It's really simple. It's pretty, and it's also got a skirt, so it could be a dress. Or it's also got a little hooded version, and this is just minus the skirt. Just eliminating
this
it.
This is what I hope to be making, right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay,
you can
good.
Make that.
So I like
this.
That.
Yeah,
I like it. Yeah.
All right. So now the first thing you have to do is you have to know what size to measure. Okay? So the first thing I do
My favorite
is,
part.
Well, you're so
and
small.
And these measurements shall
I will tell. Oh, yes. 86. No. Okay. So, all right. So listen, we'll take your little hip measurement here. So what we've got on here is... Boy, I would not be embarrassed if I were a size B, because on here you match up your bust, waist, and hip, and she is a size B at the bust and C at the hip, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, let's look at the pattern, and where do we find the size? If the pattern's opened up, and do you see down, you look down here at the bottom, You always start at the bottom or the top, A, B, C. So see, this is the C cutting line. And you'll notice each line...
So that's the hip, so that's why I'm cutting C, because
right.
that's the hip.
And then we're gonna go up here.
Okay,
now, you'll see that the C line is solid throughout, and the B line is long, long, long with dots
Got
in
it.
Between.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I just put that to remind you that when we get down there, we better be to the C.
Okay.
Now... Let's go up here and let's look at where the ABC. Now see how it gets confusing up here with the dots? One of the things you have to realize is that dots are always in 5/8 of an inch from the seam line. So I usually come down to the bottom and I look down here, AB. So here is the B.
And that's the
see?
C. Okay.
So what I do is now why don't you trace out that B.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm good at this part right here.
Okay, so trace that out.
All right. Okay.
And you know, you don't have to be perfect on it.
Oh, don't you have to worry about that?
That's for sure.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Okay. Oh,
keep going.
So,
I see now.
Yeah, I'm confused because now it looks like I'm heading to D.
See, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
Here we are. We come up to here, and it says D, but see, remember I said that the dots are always in 5/8 of an inch from that. So don't pay attention to the dots now.
Okay, okay.
You can mark. Now see, now come back here. See,
here's
A, B.
Okay, and this is at the neck.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, now, what are we going to do at the hip? All right, so here we are now. We're here. Okay, now see, this can be confusing because you think, where's the bigger size?
Mm-hmm.
Just keep track of what your line looked like, see? This was kind of the broken line, so
right.
I keep following. So the broken line is here.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to stick with this line all the way in to about the bust.
Okay.
Now, which is right under about the arm. So what I have to do is I have to get from here. See, here's the B.
Right.
So we want to go from here and then just kind of start angling in. Don't make it too abrupt.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yeah.
Now, let's look closely at the pattern. What else? These are notches. See these little things here?
Mm-hmm.
And they're kind of like little, if you had a puzzle, they're like a little shape. They're going to show you what to match. See, here's another one up here. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And so, now, what is this dot down here? Okay, and then this is the waistline, but these little measurements, that is what that measures. So, see the B, okay, down
32.
Here. 32, and yeah, that's plenty of room for you, do you see, finished around here. And you can always check
Oh yeah, let's just.
No, I mean you
can... 32.
There
okay.
it is.
Okay, that's
no,
good.
But you can
yeah,
always,
we're fine with that. So okay.
Isn't that funny?
Can we
you
cut
know,
this now?
When you're Kim's age, you're embarrassed.
Oh
when you're right, you don't...
my!
So now you
okay.
can. What I would do is I just cut. Don't worry about cutting right
These
on it. Just cut off the
scissors.
Excess.
Okay. Oh, just cut off the excess. Don't cut on the line.
No, just because oh. we'll cut it out when we go.
Is okay? that a little trick of the trade?
That yeah, I think it's faster.
Okay.
Don't be accurate. Just
oh,
do a
I like this.
Fast
right.
and dirty
okay,
thing.
Okay, good. Got it.
And.
And then when I get the fabric on it, then I can be more detailed.
Right.
Okay.
And then we do the same thing with this one, do you see?
Mm-hmm.
So this is really kind of a pretty simple thing. It's go ahead. You keep going.
But now if I have to match the back, do I have to match it exactly the same way you sort of did that curve?
Yes. And so I'll show you how to okay. do that. That's why I'm gonna trace this out for you.
All right.
So I'm still following. Remember those dots. Don't let those dots confuse you. Because I think they confuse everybody. And if you just remember that they're 5/8 of an inch in. And mark your little notches there like that. And if you just look at the bottom and identify it there. See how it gets a little confusing over here? I don't know where the A and the B are. Here's my B again. Because
okay.
I looked, see I saw the little letter down there. There's my B.
Mm-hmm.
Now, keep going up here to here it is.
Okay.
And what I have to do is I have to get out here to see.
But now should I be looking at where I did this one?
Yes. What
oh.
you can do
okay.
is you can wing it, which is probably
oh,
most...
Oh, I like that idea. Yeah.
Yeah. You could lay it there
okay.
and do the exact, but we know you're not going to do
oh,
that.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So
just
you're
sort
just
of about
wing.
Where you started
yeah.
going in.
Yeah.
Then that's where I got
okay.
in. Okay.
So now we're set with this. All right. Now, what are the other pieces involved? See, if you look inside of the pattern, it gives you a little idea of what pieces in the layout inside that, you
mm-hmm.
know, so we'll do that in a minute. But let's
okay.
take that. Here's your little hooded piece. So
okay.
that's all set.
Okay.
And there are two last pieces, which are little facings. And so you want to make sure, usually when you have facings.
Which I don't like, but you're trying to get me to use those,
no, but
right?
these would be also... On the back of the pattern here, it says under notions, it says that you need some interfacing. What is interfacing? Interfacing is a little bit of stabilizer that's going to stiffen it up a little bit. For example, like you do pockets and waistbands and sometimes facings. And so what I mean when I cut these out of the fashion fabric,
mm-hmm.
I would also cut them out of the interfacing. And I like the little knitted interfacings of the woven, lightweight, go lighter rather than heavier, rather than the non-woven. The non-woven, it just ends up looking like a sophisticated
Can
Kleenex.
I use that same type of interfacing for everything that I make?
Yeah, and if you
oh,
want a little
nice.
More, you can just layer it up. So
okay.
like fusing knit would be a great all-purpose one.
Okay.
So what do you think?
About what?
Power sewing.